Let me see what the card says. It says...
You haven't read my card.
Yes, I have. And I'm reading on camera. Russell Walker for House District 48. Garland Pearson office 14 years. Time for a change. End the war on drugs. No income tax on wages. Homestead exemption. Repeal the food tax. Criminal justice reform. Fair trials. Stop no-knock searches and police murders. You sound like a Democrat.
That's right. The two counties in my district, Scotland and Hope, have never in their 100-and-something-year history ever voted for a Republican. Now you have the paradox of a Republican running on what you call a Democratic themes, to some degree.
You won the primary.
No, won the primary.
With how much of the vote?
2-1. All these news media, they know how to answer. The Southern mentality is one which... Yeah, I've studied it most of my life. I still don't totally understand it, but I know how to jab them badly. I have a signed name. It cost me $15. You know, you can make a handmade sign. It's a handmade sign. These signs are well made, I think. That's just the way I do things. One side says, "What's wrong with being a racist?" That's a... you got to realize, I've used this stuff on hundreds of people on the internet and other people. They have no answers.
What does the other side say? If God is a racist.
Right.
Explain that.
Well, God made the racist. If he didn't make the racist, who made them?
Yeah, but racist usually means that you discriminate, hold them in different regard, which you clearly do.
I do, and so does God.
God likes, for example, whites more than black.
Yes, Christ said he came only to lost sheep in the house of Israel. That's another story. We can go to the bigotry and everything else we want to.
Wait, but God, so God prefers whites over
Muslims? Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
How about blacks over Muslims?
I have no idea. They're all the same.
So imagine, pre-civil rights, you believe in white superiority. The laws are based off of this. Culture is based off of this. Segregation was based off the idea that whites were superior and deserved their own space because this was their country. The end of segregation argues something substantially different. It shifts the idea of white people being fully actualized citizens to anyone in this country being able to be fully actualized citizens. Now imagine you are someone who believes you're superior, and now you've just lost to these folks who you saw were inferior. You can't accept that. And so you begin to look for other answers. And the other answers that were created was the idea that it couldn't have been black folks at all. They weren't smart enough. They weren't creative. It had to be a secret force. And that secret force becomes the Jew.
The Jew was created to destroy the white Christian nations. Power in the house. Do you think the whites of this country demanded the civil rights laws? Do you think they demanded integration of the schools? You think that they wanted the current immigration society of mostly black, brown, black, whatever you call them, into this society? The white society in this country is being destroyed.
A quick history of Jews being blamed for things. Since biblical times, Jews have been blamed for the death of Jesus. In some countries, they still are. My hippie uncle Mike was accused of killing Christ in 1972. "I had nothing to do with it, man. I was in Florida," he said. In the Middle Ages, Jews were blamed for the Black Plague. Jews were accused of kidnapping and killing Christian children. Jews were, and still are, accused of creating capitalism, running the banks, and running the media. In the 1800s, some people wrote a book that said that Jews were trying to control the world. And Henry Ford helped distribute 500,000 copies in the U.S. Hitler blamed the Jews for the problems of Germany, and through the centuries, untold numbers of Jews have been punished and killed for these and thousands of other made-up allegations.
Anti-Semitism is a conspiracy theory. It's a conspiracy theory, the notion that there is this group out there, these forces out there, that are more powerful than you. They may be smaller in number than you, but they exert an unbelievable amount of power.
It begins with the idea that the Jews are evil, that they are children of Satan.
Christ told the Jews their father was Satan. What do you say about that? John 8:44.
These Jewish false prophets, anti-Christian, anti-God, you know, they're willing to put Jesus to death again.
That they are motivated by a desire to destroy what is good in society.
You know what this comedian